Milk is one of the more nutritious foods we have, and its popularity is reflected in how commonly it's consumed worldwide. But is drinking milk good if you're trying to lose weight? Hi, I'm Dr. Brian Young, a naturopathic doctor in Toronto. Let's talk about milk and if you should drink it for weight loss. With so many possible substitutes and alternatives that are also called milk, for the sake of this video, we'll focus on the milk coming from animals. Nut and plant-based milks like almond milk may have some interesting benefits and drawbacks over animal milks, but we won't go into it in this video. We'll address it in another video, so subscribe and stay tuned. Milk is the liquid produced by mammals, which is a type of animal, and is the main source of nutrition for their young. It's produced by every mammal, such as humans or cows. Technically, mammals are the only types of animals that produce milk. Although some animals that are not mammals produce milk-like substances for their young, this is not considered milk. This is because milk technically comes from mammary glands, and these milk-like substances do not come from such glands. For example, pigeons and flamingos produce a milk-like substance known as bird's milk or crop milk, which is produced by a small sac-like structure at the base of their neck called the crop, and is regurgitated out to their young. But because the crop is not composed of mammary glands, we don't technically consider this real milk. All mammals produce milk, although not all of them have nipples for their young to directly drink the milk from. For example, the platypus is a mammal that lacks nipples and secretes the milk out from pores on her skin. Essentially, she sweats milk and her babies will lick her skin to drink the milk. Cow versus goat milk. Although milk from other mammals such as buffaloes and camels are available in certain markets, we will focus on the two most commonly available milks, which is cow's milk and goat's milk. A glass of goat milk has more overall calories than cow milk. This is because goat milk tends to have a little more protein and fat, as well as a little less sugars as whole fat cow milk. As a result, drinking a glass of goat's milk might be slightly more filling and hunger suppressing than cow milk. Goat milk may be slightly more nutritious and have a greater amount of nutrients like vitamin A, C, and other minerals than cow's milk, and may help improve the absorption of iron from your food. Goat milk also has slightly less lactose in it, making it somewhat more tolerable for those who are lactose intolerant or can't digest cow milk properly. Goat milk has a distinct and stronger taste to it, with some people describing it as grassy or tangy, with a thicker texture that may take some getting used to. It's also significantly more expensive and less widely available than cow's milk. Keep in mind that here in North America, cow milk is much more commonly consumed than goat milk. However, it's interesting to note that worldwide, goat milk is much more commonly consumed. Overall, the decision to choose goat milk versus cow milk should be mostly based on your own personal preferences. If cow milk causes you significant bloating and gas, goat milk may be a suitable alternative. However, if the high cost and strange taste of goat milk isn't worth the minor nutritional differences, there's no need to force yourself to switch over to goat's milk. Nutrition-wise, you aren't going to be missing out on much by drinking cow's milk instead of goat's milk. Fat content of milk. When you shop for milk, it's generally divided into whole milk, reduced fat milk, low fat milk, and fat-free milk, also known as skim milk. With regards to vitamin and mineral content, there isn't a significant difference between them all, due to the standard fortification of all these milks. Higher fat content milks may have more flavor to them and may help reduce appetite better than lower fat content milks. However, they also understandably have a higher calorie density due to their fat content. Again, which milk you decide to use depends on your preferences. If you get hungry easily, higher fat milks will help suppress appetite better. But if your diet depends partially on counting calories, you might prefer lower fat milks that are lower in overall calories. So, can drinking animal milk help with weight loss? Let's go over some of its strengths and weaknesses. Strength: provides good nutrition. Deficiencies in calcium and vitamin D may make it more difficult for your body to properly lose weight and slow down fat loss. Milk provides a good amount of calcium, and because in Canada, milk is also fortified with vitamin D, albeit not a lot, it also provides some vitamin D. It also contains a number of B vitamins and minerals that are involved in the metabolic process of breaking down fat. Weakness: high calorie density. Although milk is mostly water by weight, as a liquid, it can contain a significant amount of calories. Even though the good amounts of protein and fat make it a much better alternative to juices or pop, the issue lies in how many people normally consume milk, which is as a drink. In most circumstances, as a drink to quench thirst, you'll have better drink alternatives for weight loss, like water, tea, or coffee with nothing added. Strength: decent protein and fat. Increasing protein and fat intake is a good way to suppress appetite and reduce hunger. They both stimulate hormones that trigger fullness signals in the body and allow you to eat less, as long as you're consuming it slowly and giving your body time to feel full. Adding milk, particularly higher fat content milks, can help increase the fullness of a coffee or tea that you're having between meals. Overall, milk can provide nutrients that are important for continued fat breakdown and metabolism while on your weight loss diet. However, if your weight loss diet is already highly nutritious and varied in content and has sufficient calcium and vitamin D, there are probably better alternatives to drinking milk, like just drinking water. But there's probably no need to eliminate it completely unless you're allergic or sensitive to it. My suggestion is that if your diet is highly restrictive, for example, in a strict vegetarian diet, and you are concerned about getting enough calcium and protein, a glass of milk may help provide you with those nutrients that are essential to proper weight loss. You could add small amounts of milk to coffee or tea to increase the fullness of that drink. For example, by adding some whole milk to your morning coffee so you're able to skip breakfast and not end up starving till lunch. Or if you get really hungry right before dinner and tend to eat a really large dinner, to have a glass of milk an hour before dinner so that you won't be as hungry when dinner rolls around and ideally end up eating a smaller dinner. Otherwise, consider quenching your thirst with just water instead. Or if you really like milk, you could go for like 1% milk. Do you drink milk on your weight loss diet? And do you prefer goat or cow's milk? Let me know in the comments down below. And if you found this video helpful, please leave me a like. As before, I'm Dr. Brian Young, bringing you weight loss info on this channel. Subscribe and hit the notification bell if you're interested in learning more, and share it with someone you know who needs the help.